Last period, we learned how to draw the similar triangles when the triangles, all three sides are given. So that is the SSS type construction of similar triangles. Now, today we are going to learn how to draw the similar triangle when one of the angle of the triangle and two corresponding sides are given. Now first, let's draw the rough figure. The name of the two triangles are triangle LTR and triangle HYD. These two triangles are given similar. Similar means their corresponding angles are congruent. Now in the question, angle Y is given 40 degree. In this triangle HYD, Y angle is here. So Y angle is corresponding angles of angle T. So since Y angle is 40 degree, so here angle T is also 40 degree. So here we are writing angle, measure of angle Y is equal to measure of angle T is equal to 40 degree. Because similar triangles, angles measurements are congruent. So therefore Y angle and T angle both are 40 degree. Now in rough figure, when we are drawing the rough figure, let's see the ratio. Ratio is given LR upon HD is equal to 5 upon 6. Ratio for triangle LTR is 5 and ratio for triangle HYD is 6. This shows that HYD triangle is bigger or larger than triangle LTR. So for rough figure also, we are drawing one smaller triangle and one larger triangle or bigger triangle. In rough figure, we have already shown the triangle LTR. Now this triangle T is corresponding angle of angle Y. So since our T vertex is this side, so Y vertex is also coming this side, Y, and L is corresponds to H, so H is here and T is here. Now angle Y is given 40 degree. So here this angle T is also 40 degree. So in rough figure, we are showing all the corresponding sides and the corresponding angles measurements, and according to our rough figure, now we are constructing the fair figure. So here the HY side is given 7.2 centimeter and VD side is given 6 centimeter. Before constructing the triangle, we have to find out the length of the triangle LT and length of the triangle TR. So for that, we are using the given ratio. In this triangle, two triangle, all the corresponding ratios are equal. So let's now write down the corresponding ratios. The ratios are LT is equal to TR upon YD is equal to LR upon HD is equal to 5 upon 6. All the ratios are equal. Now let's substitute the given values from the question. Now in this question, HY is given, so LT remains as it is upon HY is 7.2, so we are putting here 7.2 is equal to. Now TR is not given, so TR also as it is upon YD is given 6 is equal to 5 upon 6. Now compare the ratios and let's find out the length of side LT and side TR. LT upon 7.2 is equal to 5 upon 6. Similarly here, TR upon 6 is equal to 5 upon 6. LT equal to 7.2 multiplied by 5 upon 6, comma TR is equal to 6 multiplied by 5 upon 6. LT is equal to. Now these two numbers are divisible. 12 multiplied by 5. So answer is coming here 6 centimeter, and here answer is coming 5 centimeter. Now we are having the corresponding sides of the triangle LTR. LT is equal to 6 centimeter and TR is equal to 5 centimeter. So let's write down in triangle LTR, LT, length LT is equal to 6 centimeter, length TR is equal to 5 centimeter, angle T is equal to 40 degree. In triangle HYD, length HY equal to 7.2 centimeter, length YD equal to 6 centimeter, and angle Y equal to 40 degree. Now we are having all the measurements of all these two similar triangles. Now let's draw the similar triangles according to the given lengths and the angles. Now we are having the side LT and TR. In these both the length, we are having the vertex T. So you can select any one of the side as a base. So now let's draw 6 centimeter LT segment and measure angle T 40 degree with the help of protractor. So put your protractor and measure angle T 40 degrees. Then take the distance 5 centimeter in compass and put the compass pointer on T, and on this ray locate point R, which is 5 centimeter distance, and then join LR. So this is the required triangle LTR. Similarly, this LT is corresponding sides of HY. So for the second triangle, draw HY side 7.2 centimeter. Measure angle Y again 40 degree with the help of protractor. And take 6 centimeter distance in compass, put the compass pointer on Y and locate point D here. So this is 6 centimeter distance. After that, join HD. So these are the two required similar triangles. The two triangles, triangle SHR and triangle SVU, are given similar triangle. Now look at these triangles' name, SHR and SVU. In these two triangles, our S vertex is common. So whenever a common vertex is there, the construction steps are different from the previous two steps. So now let's see how these two triangles are constructed when one of the vertex of the two triangles is common. For that also, first we draw the rough figure. This is our common vertex S. Now the ratio SH upon SV is given in the question 3 upon 5. Triangle SHR, the length SH is there, and in triangle SVU, SV length is given. So SH and SV are the corresponding sides of the two triangles, which is having the ratio 3 upon 5. This ratio shows that triangle SHR is smaller than triangle SVU. So S vertex is common, so just First, we draw the rough figure of the corresponding sides of the triangle. The bigger triangle is SVU. S, which is SH. S. Figure where the one of the vertex S is common between the two triangles. So rough figure according to the given lengths of the triangles is like this. So SHR and SVU, these are the two required triangles we are going to construct. Now the steps of the construction are different from the previous one. In the previous example, we are finding the corresponding lengths of the triangle. So here, there is no need to find out the lengths of the triangle. So just the steps of the constructions I am showing now, how to draw the construction of the two similar triangles when one of the vertex is common. The triangle SHR, the lengths are given. SH is 4.5 cm, HR is 5.2 cm. And RS is 5.8 cm. From the given lengths, first we construct the required triangle SHR. Now, SH we are taking as a base. So, length SH, measure length SH with the help of the ruler 4.5 cm. Then, take 5.2 cm distance in compass and put the compass pointer on H. Draw the arc. Again take 5.8 cm distance in compass, put the compass pointer on S and construct the intersecting arc so that the point R is located. Then join SR and RH. After constructing the triangle, extend the side SH or produce the side SH in this way. Then from the common vertex, draw the ray opposite to the vertex R. Like this. Make sure that angle form between the side SH and the ray which we are now going to draw is always acute angle. It is not obtuse angle. It is of acute angle, less than 90 degree. Then now the rough figure. From the rough figure, this side SH we are now extend and then we draw the ray opposite in the opposite direction of the common vertex S. Now look at the ratio. The ratios are 3 upon 5. Among this 3 upon 5 ratio, 5 is the largest ratio. So whatever is the largest ratio, that ratios we are drawing the arcs or the ratios on these ray, where we draw this ray. So take some sufficient distance in compass, put the compass pointer on S and draw the 5 equal parts. So this is the first equal part, don't change the distance. Second equal part, second part, third part, fourth part and the fifth part. So now let's give the name S1, S2, S3, S4 and S5. So this ray is divided into 5 SHR. In this SHR, SH ratio is 3. So from this vertex H, join this third part, that is S3, like this. Draw the segment FHS3 like this. we want to locate the point V on this ray which we extend from SH side. So here we want the point V. So point V can be located here on this, so that for that we are now taking some distance in compass. Put the compass pointer on S3 and draw the arc like this on this side, so that this arc intersect this side HS3 and ray SS3 in these two points. Do not change the distance of the compass. Put the compass pointer on S5. S5 ratio, our this ratio is 5. So put the compass pointer on this S5 and draw the arc like this. Then again come to here, this point. Take the distance between these two intersection points in the compass. Put the compass pointer on this point where this arc intersects the ray, and draw the intersecting arc like this. Then from this intersection and this ratio S5, draw the parallel segment passing through from these intersection point and S5. Draw the parallel. Make sure that your segment is coming parallel to HS3, so that our point V is located here in a correct ratio. So if your segment is not parallel, the location of the point is wrong. So make sure that if the line is not coming parallel, you have to construct once again the arcs corrected, and draw the segment parallel to HS3. After locating point V, now our required point is the U point. So for this point, again we extend SR in this way, SR. Reduce SR so that our point U locate here on this ray. Now to locate the point U, we are considering this angle, because this angle H and this angle V both are congruent. Already we are having H angle, so to locate or to construct a congruent angle, first we put the compass pointer on H, draw the arc like this. Do not change the distance of the compass. Put the compass pointer on V and draw the arc on this ray, extended ray HV, like this. Then take the intersection distance between these two points. Put the compass pointer on the intersection point where this arc intersects the ray, and draw the intersection arc like this. Draw the intersection arc. From this intersection point and the point V which we locate, again draw the parallel segment passing through from this intersection and V. This is the required U point. So in this way, triangle SVU is constructed, which is similar to SHR. This is the required figure. For example, I am showing the same type. In this example, triangle LMN is similar to triangle LQP. In these two triangles, L vertex is common. In triangle LMN, the lengths are given. LM length is given 3.6, angle L is given 50 degree, and LN is given 4.2. And ratio LM upon LQ is given 4 upon 7. This ratio LM upon LQ shows that The triangle LU is larger triangle and triangle LM is smaller triangle. So now first we draw the rough figure. So this is the required rough figure. Now from this rough figure, now first we construct triangle LMN, which is the given measure according to the given measurements. Length LM is given 3.6. So now let's construct length LM 3.6 with the help of ruler. LM 3.6 centimeter. Then with the help of protractor, measure angle L 50 degree. Then take 4.2 centimeter distance in compass, put the compass pointer on L and locate point N. Join MN. So triangle LMN is constructed according to the given measurements. Now we are now going to draw the triangle, similar triangle LPQ. For that we are going to extend the side LM in this way. From the common vertex again we are drawing the opposite ray to the vertex L in this way. Make sure that the angle is acute angle only. Now the ratio LM upon LQ is given 4:7. The largest or highest ratio is 7. So now we are dividing 7 equal parts on this ray, taking some distance in compass. So take some distance in compass, put the compass pointer on L and draw the 7 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, like this, and give the name L1, L2, L3, L4, L5, L6 and here is L7. The ratio LM is given 4, so our fourth ratio is L4. This L4 is joined to the vertex M like this. So seg ML4 is constructed. When we construct length segment ML4, the angle L4M is constructed or formed. This angle we are constructing at the ratio L7, so that we can locate the point Q on this extended ray. So here take some distance in compass, put the compass pointer on L4 and draw the arc like this. Do not change the distance. Come here to the point L7, put the compass pointer on L7 and draw the arc, put the compass pointer on L7 and draw the arc. Then take the intersection distance between the compass where we have already drawn the previous arc which touch the two side ML4 and LL4 at these two points. So take this distance between intersection point in compass and put the compass pointer on the point where the arc intersect the ray. So put the compass pointer here on this point and draw the intersection arc to this arc. So we are having intersection point here. From this intersection point and the ratio L7, pass the segment. Pass the segment from this point so that this segment and this segment, these two are parallel to each other. And and our point Q is located here on this ray, which is having the ratio 4.7. So now our P point is remaining. To locate point P, again this angle M and angle Q both are congruent. We are already having angle M here, we want the angle Q exactly the same measurement. So for that, again take some distance again in compass, put the compass pointer on M, draw the arc which intersect MN and LM in two different points. Do not change this distance. Come to this point Q which is just now we located, put the compass pointer on Q and draw the arc like this. Now take the intersection distance between the compass, put the compass pointer on this point where the arc intersect the ray and draw the intersection arc. Draw the intersection arc. From this intersection point and point Q, pass the segment from these two. So that is the point P. Again, make sure that again these two sides are also parallel to each other. So this is the required two similar triangles.